Welcome! This is Dr. Plague. And today on Dr. Plague, we're what's that?
I want a hamster!
Oh, okay. Where are you going to keep this hamster?
I don't know.
Then, today, we're going to make a bin cage for a hamster. You're not going to want to miss this, so stick around.
We're going to make a bin cage for a hamster. And one thing to note is that hamsters need a lot of space. They should have at least 450 square inches of floor space, or more if possible. A hamster with a small cage is an unhappy hamster. So we went to Walmart and bought the biggest bin we could find. You can see it measures 39¾ by 21½ inches. So you might be tempted to say it calculates to almost 855 square inches. But wait, this isn't accurate. So, let's measure the actual inside dimensions. We come up with about 19 by 37 inches for 703 square inches, but this still isn't correct. We need to measure from the bottom to get a better idea of the minimum area, which is about 17 by 34 inches for a total of 578 square inches. Notice that the sides slant outwards as we get closer to the top, so the area will be affected by the amount of bedding that we place in the bin. We will have a separate video on how to come up with a better approximation of the area depending on the depth of the bedding by using a method called linear interpolation. We are going to modify the lid of this bin to add some wire, hardware cloth, so the little guy inside can breathe. Let's go out in the shop and get started. So, here's a quick tour of the shop that we'll be working in. You can see we have a surface planer, a scroll saw, a lathe, some sanders, a drill press, a bench jointer, bandsaw, a drum sander, a cabinet table saw with a router table built onto the side of it, a miter saw, and our workbench, to name a few items. So, here's the hardware cloth we'll be using. We're going to find a way to make a large opening and apply it across the width of the lid. The idea is to build a wooden frame that the wire cloth will be held in with. So, we'll use 1x3 aspen boards for this, which are actually 3/4 inch by 2½ inches. One is 3 feet long and the other is 6 feet. We're going to make kerf cuts at the table saw down the edges of these that we can use to hold the wire cloth in place. A little fancy for a bin cage, but let's go with it. Before we get started, let's talk about shop safety. Be sure to read and follow all the instructions to all your power tools. Well, maybe just the ones you're going to be using. Do not underestimate the power of your power tools and always respect their limitations. You probably don't want to cut a log at the table saw. Always wear respiratory protection when creating breathable dust. Be sure to wear eye protection. Yeah, he can never be too safe. Protect your hearing. Finally, take care of any loose clothing and tie back any long hair. Make sure everything is nice and secure. Yeah, don't use plastic wrap. Only now are we ready to use any tools. So, the first thing I want to do is I want to measure to the center of a 6-foot length of aspen and mark it with a 45-degree line so we have two usable long sides. That way, each side can be a little longer than 3 feet since we'll be cutting it at an angle. Now, with the miter saw set to a 45-degree angle, we'll make the cut. Perfect. Now, we're going to do something that we normally should never do. We're going to remove the blade guard on the table saw, since we will not be cutting all the way through the boards to make the kerf cuts. I'm calling them kerf cuts since we'll be using the kerf of the blade to cut a groove all the way down the edge of each board. So, I'm going to slide the fence over and set the table saw up for making the kerf cuts. So, you can see the blade is set up to run a groove down the edge of the board. Now, I'm going to clamp up a guide for the boards so they can ride against the fence. Perfect. The blade is raised to about 3/4 of an inch. Now, we make the kerf cuts. And there we have them. Now, we'll cut the 3-foot piece in half with the short sides. Next, I'll line up one end of the short sides and cut the other ends together to make them the same length. Perfect. Now, I'll do the same for the long sides. Beautiful. We're going to sand the grooved edges by using 3 different grits of sandpaper, starting with 60, then 120, and finally 220 grit. Now, we're going to paint these edges, since they'll be difficult to paint once the wire cloth is inserted. We're going to use white non-toxic tempera paint. And we're going to add in a little brown food coloring. Then we'll mix this up nicely. And start the painting. Gotta clean up the drips a bit. Okay, now we're gonna cut the wire cloth to fit the wooden frame. So, let's open the package. And clamp it down for cutting. I'm just using side cutters to do this. Yeah, you know, it takes a little time to get it all cut up, but we're getting there. Yeah, you know, you can probably hear one of our neighbors doing some sawing in the background. Good day to get some work done. Now we have it all cut up and inserted into the frame. We need to get it all glued up and clamped. By the way, this is the hardware cloth that we're using. It states that it's ideal for small pet enclosures. Now, here it is, all glued and clamped.
So, we've just started making our bin cage for the hamster. We're gonna let the glue dry and we'll come back for part two. So if you like this, please be sure to peck that like button and don't forget to subscribe. We'll see you next time right here on Dr. Clay.